Om Shri Sai Ram.
We, the students of Shri Satya Sai University, Prashanthi Nilayam Campus, offer a humble presentation entitled Shri Krishna Tattva Darshanamu at the Divine Lotus Feet of our most beloved Mother Sai.
Of Vrindavan, for it carries the memories of my Lord's footprints for eternity. O Vrindavan, accept the salutations of this humble servant of the Lord, Vidura. Ah, the breeze of Vrindavan carries with it the fragrance of devotion, and the atmosphere is filled with Krishna rasa.
Thank you.
చూడాలిని ఆబాల గోపాలం వేచేనయ్యా
Swami, even after all these years of association with you, this pain of separation scorches my soul, my Lord. Oh, oh, the Gopalas and the Gopikas who consider you as their very life breath must be suffering.
Oh, holy sire, who are you? Are you searching for something?
People identify me as Vidura. But Gopalas, tell me, as to how you are able to bear this suffering of not having Krishna amidst you?
Mahatma, you must be mistaken. For Krishna has never left us. In the bright rays of the morning sun, he showers his warmth on all of us.
In the cool waters of the Yamuna, he slakes our thirst and satiates us. In the pleasant breeze and in the flowers and the trees, he plays the nectarine tunes of his flute for us.
When Krishna is everywhere, how does the question of his absence even arise, O Mahatma?
I am indeed blessed to be in the company of such enlightened souls like you, Gopalas. You have made me realize that I have not yet understood the Krishna Tattva. You have given me a goal, a purpose, the quest for true Brahma Jnana.
Mahatma, we are but simple cowherds. What would we know about such great things? Look, Vidurji, look. Here comes Krishna's intimate friend, Uddhava. Maybe he can help you.
Krishna Saka, Uddhava. Accept my pranams.
Pranams, Dharmatma. I was just returning from Dwaraka. Blessed with the sweet and sublime wisdom from Vasudeva.
Then kindly share that wisdom with me, Uddhava, so that this quest of mine shall culminate on this holy soil of Vrindavan.
Dharmatma, Krishna had already predicted this tryst between us. he wanted me to convey on his behalf that you must meet Maharishi Maitreya, and it is from him that you will receive the true knowledge. Mahatma, let me take your leave now.
Maharishi Maitreya, Dhanyosmi Prabhu, Dhanyosmi. Pranams, Maharishi Maitreya.
Mahatma Vidura.
Maharishi, I have come here by Krishna's command to receive the true meaning of Brahma Tattva from you. Mahatman, please bless me with that nectarine knowledge and liberate me.
Mahatma, you are already a great Jnani. What extra learning can I think of imparting you? But as Krishna has willed this meeting, let us discuss his glory, his leelas.
Krishna's leelas. Krishna is the sanctuary of sweetness which gets distributed to all through his leelas. His message is like a song that takes the listeners to a different world.
But the greatest song the master musician had ever composed is the song celestial, Bhagavad Gita. But Vidura, Gita is not just a compendium of verses delivered on the battlefield. It is his grand orchestra, his glorious life. In fact, his life is verily his message.
True, Mahatman, the canvas of his glory is painted with insolence in which he fulfilled the promises declared in the Gita.
Yes, his thought and deed were always for the welfare of the devotees who displayed total surrender. Experience his glory, Vidura. Relive the experience. Watch as the Pandavas surrendered to his lotus feet and sought shelter from the anger of sage Durvasa.
If not for us, who else could have rendered such impeccable service for 4 long months to the hallowed sage Durvasa and his entourage of 10,000 disciples?
It is true, Suyodhana. Hospitality is the hallmark of the Guru dynasty.
My dear Bhanje Suyodhana, hospitality is the best way to end hostilities. This is the best chance that you have to annihilate the Pandavas once and for all.
Gandhar Naresh, for once, let us fight like Kshatriyas on the battlefield. Suyodhana, let us end this conflict in a royal way.
Radheya, a simple throw of dice had achieved what your arrows could not. Do not underestimate the power of statecraft, Karna.
Yes, Karna. Mama Shri is correct. So tell me, Mama Shri, what do you have in mind?
Suyodhana, use Durvasa's Agraha as the Astra against the Pandavas. Let the curse at the tip of the Rishi's tongue become the bane for the Pandavas and a boon for the Kauravas. The Rishi is mighty pleased with your hospitality and will definitely grant you a boon.
Understood, Mama Shri. Leave the rest to me.
Yuvraj Suyodhan.
Pranams, Munivarya.
Ayushman Bhava.
Dushasana, did you make the arrangements for the Mahatma's rest?
Every arrangement has been made, brother. And I have personally...
Do not take any more pains for me, Vats. It's time for me to leave. I am extremely pleased with your devotion. Ask. Ask from me any boon, no matter how valuable or hard. I shall grant it.
Munivarya, the opportunity to serve saints like you is itself a blessing. But I have one small request. Just as you blessed us with your darshan, it is my desire that my brothers, the Pandavas, too must be given a chance to serve your lotus feet. And...
Suyodhana, do not hesitate. Rishi Maharaj is benevolence personified. He will definitely heed your prayer.
One last request. Please visit the Pandavas only after Sister Panchali has had her meal.
So be it. I shall definitely bless the Kaunteyas with my visit.
Very soon, the Pandavas will be burnt to ashes in the fire of Durvasa's temper. And Yuvraj Suyodhan will become
Maharaj Suyodhan.
Agraja, with every passing day of exile, my mace is getting more and more eager to cleanse the Bharatvarsha of the evil Kauravas. If only you would have permitted, I would have finished the task long ago.
Bhimasena, have patience.
If we too are ruled by the surging emotions instead of the inner conscience, what is the difference between us and Duryodhana? This is a trial of fire from which we shall emerge purified.
But what about the comforts in which our evil cousins are rejoicing and the misery in which we are languishing?
Bhima, as our beloved Vasudeva has said, that too shall pass. This too shall pass.
Om Namah Shivaya. Om Namah Shivaya.
Munivarya, what a pleasant surprise. Your visit to our humble hermitage has sanctified all our lives.
Dharmaraj, all the pleasantries can wait. First, my 10,000 disciples and I are suffering from intense hunger. Make arrangements for food to be served. We will go to the river for a bath and return.
But Agraja, it is well past noon. Panchali must have had her food by now, and the power of the Akshaya Patra would be over for the day.
Then how are we going to serve the massive retinue of the sage? He has a short temper and moreover, he is hungry. God knows what terrible curse he will hurl on us.
Draupadi? Draupadi?
Natha, what is the matter?
Devi, Maharshi Durvasa has arrived with his disciples. If we are not able to feed them, we are bound to be cursed by him.
But Swami, how are we going to feed them? I've already had my lunch.
What is this play of destiny, Agraja? The ruler of the world and torchbearer of righteousness, unable to feed a single hungry Brahmin?
Vela kolandi viprulako Munindra Kotikin. Vela Kolandi Sadhulaku Bidalakun. Mari Arthikotikin Melaku Bhojanambu. మితిమీరగ పెట్టడి మీకు అక్కటా ఏలకో పట్టెడన్నమునకే కరువేర్పడే
Dharmo rakshati rakshita. One who follows dharma shall never be harmed.
And where there is dharma, there is Krishna. He is our sole refuge. Shri Krishna.
Krishna,
Madhusudana, Janardana, Keshava, Sodari Panchali.
Krishna,
I am very hungry. Please serve me some food.
Even now you are testing us, Krishna. Hey Hridayvasi, you know our inner torment. Please rescue us.
First feed me, then we will discuss all your problems.
There is nothing left, Vasudeva. Only the empty vessel and our empty hands.
I don't believe that. There must be something. At least a grain of rice. Get the vessel, sister.
Vrajishnur bhojanam bhota sahishnur jagadadi jaha anagho vijayo jeta vishwayo nir punar vasu.
May this leaf satisfy not only me, but the entire universe.
Bhimasena, go and fetch the venerable sage and his disciples. Do not accept any excuses from them. Did you understand?
Understood, Vasudeva. Years of your company has rubbed a little bit of mischief in me too.
Krishna, Papad Bandhava, you have rescued us yet again. Any words of gratitude would fail to quantify your infinite love for us.
It is not just love, Dharmaja. It is my duty too. For those who have contemplated on me ceaselessly, their protection and well-being becomes my responsibility.
Ananyas chintayanto ma ye jana paryupasate tesham nitya abhiyuktana yogakshemam vaha
Om Namah Shivaya. Om Namah Shivaya. Om Namah Shivaya. Om Namah Shivaya. Om Namah Shivaya.
Gurudeva. Gurudeva. Though we have eaten nothing, our stomach seem to be bursting with food. Help us, Gurudeva. Help us.
What nonsense are you talking? Just a few minutes back, you were so hungry. Now, what happened?
Shiv Shiva.
Pranams, Munivarya. Agraja has prepared a variety of dishes to serve you, Your Holiness. Please bless us by accepting our hospitality.
Bhimasena, there is no place in my stomach even for a single grain of rice. I am not even in a position to walk.
Maharishi, if you don't mind, I shall carry you on my back and take you to the hermitage in a moment.
Please leave me, Bhimasena. Understand my plight. I cannot accept your invitation.
That is not possible, Munivarya. My brother will take me to task if I reach the hermitage without thy hallowed self. By the way, Madhusudana is also waiting for you.
Madhusudana? Krishna? Now I understand that this is all your divine Leela, Lord. I was tricked by that evil Duryodhana who convinced me with all sweet words soaked in hypocrisy.
That dusht Duryodhana again?
All those who have sent me here with evil intentions will be destroyed. Please send my sincere apologies to Vasudeva. As long as he is by your side, crisis will shudder to come near you. Vijayi Bhava. Sri Krishna Kripa Katakcha Siddhirastu.
The next step on the spiritual ladder is to give up all dharmas and take refuge in Him. He then absolves you of all sin and secures victory for you. The Pandavas had only one dharma, and that was to follow Krishna. And Krishna in turn saved them from unseen dangers, like the vow of Bhishma on the 8th day of Kurukshetra.
Pranams Pitamah, Pranams Guruvari.
Yashasvi Bhav.
Ayushman Bhav Vatsa. Pitamaha and I were discussing about tomorrow's battle formation.
Suyodhana, I fail to conceive any reason for your nocturnal venture. Is there any crisis that we fail to foresee?
We are amidst the greatest battle of our times. What greater crisis could we hope for? Oh, grandsire, every day becomes a lost trail of my victory, and the arrogance of the Pandavas doesn't seem to abate.
In your fragile, impatient temperament, you refuse to see the dwindling numbers of your enemy. Regiments of their soldiers are being dispatched to Yamaloka.
But, Pitamaha, what is the use of slaughtering herds of sheep, leaving the roaring lions to prowl? The sons of Pandu are making merry under your watchful eyes, O Supreme Commander.
The Kaunteyas are an invincible force, shielded further by the presence of Vasudeva. I have already told you, I shall not kill the sons of Pandu. In fact, they cannot be killed by anyone.
Pitamaha, sometimes I wonder on whose side you're fighting, ours or theirs.
I am not fighting on any side, Suyodhana. I am fighting on the side of Hastinapura.
Then will you allow Hastinapura to go down on its knees in submission to the enemy? I can sense a treacherous surprise willing to surface any moment.
Control your violent impulses, Suyodhana. Your immature emotions must not tarnish the blemishless persona of Pitamaha. The world knows about his terrible vows and his unparalleled loyalty to Hastinapura.
Forgive him, Gurudeva. He has already lost 24 brothers to the malicious mace of Bhima. He harbored false dreams of victory under the Pitamaha's banner, only to wake up in a terrible nightmare.
Do not try to test my composure with your wit and sarcasm, Gandhar Naresh. Wagging tongues do not win wars. Blazing arrows do.
But none of your arrows seem to have done any harm to the Pandavas, Pitamaha. Lay down your arms and take rest. Let me test the invincibility of the Pandavas.
You take rest, Radheya. Have you forgotten your cowardly flight at Dvaitavana and your shameful defeat in the Virata War? An Ardharati discoursing me on the vagaries of victory.
Enough is enough, Pitamaha. As the representative of the king, this is my order. Leave the battlefield and let Karna take your place.
After I put my life on stake for you, this is the honor that you wish to bestow on me. A day has come when the loyalty of Gangaputra Bhishma is being questioned. All right. Let my soul shatter and my vow be falsified. I shall blot the sun with my arrows and bring the wrath of Rudra to shame. I will be the prophet of doom for the Pandavas if that is what destiny demands of me.
Huh? Arjuna, you seem to be in some deep thought. I hope I am not intruding.
Where does the question of intrusion arise for the omniscient one, Vasudeva? Your arrival is the only happy moment I can relish at this juncture. Every other thing is bitter about this war, Krishna. The fury of Pitama has further sunk the morale of our army, and the goal of victory seems to be more elusive than ever.
I think you should have opted for the Narayani Sena Partha. Instead, you chose this unarmed charioteer who is becoming a burden on you all.
Hey, Sanatana Sarathi, I shall never regret the choice I have made. If it is our destiny to lose, we would be more than happy to lose by your side. The glory of victory pales to insignificance in front of your divine company.
Then what about your terrible vows? Is it not your dharma to keep up your vows? Or are you ready to forsake them?
We have no greater dharma other than your word, Keshava. Let your will shape our destiny.
Arjuna, the garland of victory shall continue to elude you as long as Kanga Putra Bhishma holds his bow. My mission is to secure the victory of dharma. Dharma is on your side, and so am I. It is time for enactment of a play that shall secure victory for an army and emancipation of a devotee.
Sarva dharma parityajya mamekam sharanam vraja aham tvam sarva papebhyo. Mokshayishyami ma shuchaha.
Listen to me carefully, sister. The fate of your husbands, as well as the war, lies in your hands. Be very careful while dealing with Pitamaha. Panchali, your sandals may make noise and alert Pitamaha. Leave them here and go.
Krishna, you carrying my sandals?
Shh. Just do as I say. Go now.
Pranams, O revered one.
Ayushman Bhava. Saubhagyavati Bhava. All right, my child. Dirghasumangali Bhava. Who are you, daughter? And what do you want?
What else can a poor daughter-in-law ask for? Except for blessings, Pitamaha.
Draupadi, you? What brings you here, Putri, at this dark hour?
Dark times provoke desperate attempts, Pitamaha. You blessed me as a Sumangali. I pray that you uphold the blessings.
So, hearing of my declaration to kill your husbands, you have extracted a blessing very cleverly from me. This act definitely bears the signature of a divine endeavor with perfect execution. Hey Jagannataka Sutradhari, Madhusudana, where are you? Come out of your hiding and present yourself.
Pranams, Pitamaha.
Hey Yashodhanandan, you have not yet lost your mischievous touch. See, what a precarious predicament you have forced me into.
Is protecting your grandsons, who are fighting for dharma, a predicament, Pitamaha? In fact, I am also helping you in fulfilling the blessing of victory you conferred on Yudhishthira on the first day of war.
All right, Vasudeva. Let it happen as you will. My dear daughter, shed all your worry. Who can harm your husbands when the protector of the universe has taken it upon himself to protect them? In fact, the very thought to harm them is enough. He will devise some ingenious plan and bail them out of trouble.
Draupadi, now you may leave. Here, wear your sandals and go. Pitamaha and I have some unfinished matter left.
Hey Bhakta Paradhina, when the entire universe moves according to your will. You submit yourself to your devotee's will. You are prepared to carry even the dusty sandals of a bhakta. If only I were the dust on Panchali's sandals, I would have been liberated by your touch. Vasudeva, can you hear a plea from this old man?
Pitamaha, a devotee need not plead with me. He can command me.
Then relieve me from the shackles of this earthly bondage, Vasudeva. This war ceases to be a war to me anymore. It is a dharma sankata that is tearing me apart from within. End this suffering once and for all, Krishna. Have mercy on me.
Shri Krishna Yadu Bhushana Narasakha Shringar Ratna Akara Lokadrohi Narendra Vamshadahana Lokeshwara Devatanika Brahmana Gogana Timarana Nirvana Sandayaka Nikun Mrukyada Trumpave Bhavalatal Nityanukam Panidhi
Bhishma, you are the very personification of Shanta Bhakti. My very kartavya is to protect the virtuous and punish the wicked. You perform your duty and I shall perform mine.
Paritranaya sadhuna vinashaya cha duskritaya dharma samsthapanarthaya sambhavami yuge yuge sambhavami yuge yuge
The greatest testing time for the Kuru Vamsha has arrived. The war has created such deep wounds that they may never be healed for eternity. A slight glimmer of hope lies in the arrival of an heir.
Agraja, a deep and unknown fear stalks me. That evil Ashwatthama has guided the cruel missile against all our progeny.
Do not harbor such unreasonable fears, brothers. Our protector Krishna has promised to save the unborn child. He will never go back on his word. Ah, there comes Draupadi. Surely she is bringing pleasant tidings about the arrival of an heir.
O Kauntiyas, the light of our clan has set even before it could rise. Uttara has delivered a stillborn child.
Panchali! This is not true. This cannot be true. What wrong have we done to deserve this? Agraja, what has this so-called victory given us except pain, guilt and tears?
Crisis has always been an eternal companion in our sojourn. We were robbed of our father's love, deprived of the rightful share of our kingdom, and made to stay in exile by a conspiracy.
endurance has lost all its meaning in the ceaseless flow of sorrow. And now, even the last ray of hope has gone, leading us to a dark and uncertain future.
No, Sahadeva. There is still one ray of hope left. The light which lit up our dark lives in exile and guided us all through our troubled times will surely dispel this impending doom.
Arjuna, Bhimasena, why is Hastinapura so silent? Dharmaja, you are still here? Make arrangements for celebrations. Are you waiting for my instructions even on these matters? Bhimasena, get the streets decorated, give charity and... Arjuna, why are you staring so? Oh, has the arrival of a grandson suddenly reminded you of your age?
The curse of Ashwatthama has taken effect. The world of Pandavas has collapsed with the death of Abhimanyu's son.
Bhimasena, your sense of humor has remained very intact. But don't utter such inauspicious words. See how peacefully he sleeps in the arms of his grandmother. Hare, he is the very image of Abhimanyu. His eyes are like Abhimanyu. Nose is like Abhimanyu. Lips are like Abhimanyu.
His breath is also like Abhimanyu, Krishna. Abhimanyu is dead, and so is his son.
Mockery has its limits, Vasudeva. Don't add more fuel to the fire of anguish already raging within us.
You are all mistaking a sleeping child for a dead. Sister Panchali, here. Give me the child.
Krishna.
Hey, Prananatha.
Hey, Keshava. वंशोद्धारका पाहि मां मधुसूदना व्हाट आर यू कंटेम्प्लेटिंग ऑन नाउ व्हेन वी वर इन सॉरो यू वर स्माइलिंग एंड नाउ व्हेन वी आर ऑल्सो हैप्पी यू सीम टू बी विथड्रॉन व्हाट इज द मैटर वासुदेवा
पार्था डू यू रिमेंबर द डे अभिमन्यु फेल. And what did you say? You then termed me as Vamshanashi. Then I was the destroyer of your clan. And now, suddenly, I am an emancipator.
Forgive me, Vasudeva. Being in your company for all these years, forgetting that you are divine, I have poured scorn on thee and hurt you.
Arjuna, when you accused me as Vamshanashi, or extolled me as Vamsodharaka, I remained unaffected. Then and now, I am the same Krishna.
Nenu devambu tadbhinnamemikanu akhanda parabrahmamo dunenu vyadhayu kleshamunanu sprishimpabodhu సచ్చిదానందుడను నిత్యతృప్తుడు భీతిన్ చందబోను అర్జున
ఫై ఆన్ మీ మధుసూదన Why on me? Even after receiving the nectarine message of the Gita and having a glimpse of your true form, the veil of delusion has not yet left me.
Dhananjaya, it is not just you. Everyone has this problem. When the infinite enters the realm of the finite, the principle of Maya accompanies him and deludes everyone around him.
Prabhu, you are the Maya Nataka Sutradhari.
And you are my Patradhari. I act, Arjuna. Every moment of my life I act. But every act of mine carries a message. Take the message behind the act, but do not take the action as my reality.
Then Lord, who is the one who is truly liberated?
కర్మ చ మే దివ్యం ఏవం యో వేత్తి తత్వతః త్యక్త్వా దేహం పునర్జన్మ నైతి మామే
Whosoever in my birth and action recognizes in true light that I am divine, he is liberated. That is the true jnana and the essence of Gita. Every breath we take, every moment we spend in the avatar's presence is his blessing. Know that he is divine. He is God. That is enough to secure his grace and our liberation.
Following the Lord is the only true dharma, mama dharma.
Let his message live through us so that our lives become his message.
Let us take the first step saying, I am yours, and surrender to him.
Let us take the second step claiming him. You are mine. And offer ourselves to him.
And finally, let us achieve the ultimate merger with the grand experience of unity, that you and I are one.
Ananda Balude
కడంటు
బాల గోవిందుడే కనువిందు చేయుచు కదలి వచ్చే
प्रेम गीत विनिपिंचगा शांति पदम चोपिंचगा
संभवामि पदे पदे अनुचुपलिके
सुजनामानस चोरुडु सुंदरांगुडु
श्रीकरुडु भगवंतुडु श्रीवासुदेवुडु
श्रीकरुडु भगवंतुडु
మార్గము భగవానుడు తెలిపిన భక్తి యోగము
భలే భలే సులభము బహు మంచి మార్గము భగవానుడు తెలిపిన భక్తి యోగము
యోగక్షేమము చూసే భగవంతుడుండగా
ఆ చింతన ఈ చింతన చేయనేలా
శరణంటే కరుణించి మోక్షమిస్తానంటే ఆ ధర్మము ఈ ధర్మము
Thank you.
शोधारका भक्तर दया